In reality, most studies of twins are of twins raised together rather than in different environments. But we can still estimate heritability by comparing the concordance of a trait between monozygotic and dizygotic twins, even when they've been raised in similar environments. So if a pair of twins matches for a trait, we call it concordance. If they don't match, then we call it discordance. The higher the concordance for a trait in monozygotic twins compared to dizygotic twins, then the higher the heritability of that trait. In other words, the higher the match in monozygotic twins when there's a non-match in dizygotic twins suggests that the difference is the genetics, that the fact that the monozygotic twins are identical whereas dizygotic twins are only half identical, right? They only share 50%. That being identical, that those genes, those genetic factors are important in making the match. Alternatively, if we found a lot of matching between monozygotic twins, as well as a lot of matching between dizygotic twins, because we know that there's a huge difference in the genetic identity between these pairs of twins, that whatever's going on with the matching likely has more to do with the environment that the twins are raised in rather than the fact that the monozygotic twins are identical, rather than genetics. For example, suppose you're interested in handedness, right or left-handedness. Taylor here is left-handed, and so is Grant. So they're concordant for handedness. Now, does this mean that handedness has a high heritability? Why or why not? Now, I want you to think about this for a second. Don't just jump the gun and put something down. Think about the question, and then come up with what you think is a good answer and put it in the text box here.